Is there something you're obsessed over? Well, you might be, but your doctor may not. I'm Dr. Rajani, and today I'm talking about five obsessions and five treatments. What is this all about? A lot of times, patients will come in and they'll be looking at things that maybe their provider, injectionist, is not concerned about, but they're listening to the patient to take a history. And there's five things that initially came to my mind. Comment below, maybe there's something you're obsessing about. What's most important is not looking at one thing, but globally the whole picture. People come in and they'll say, I want to look younger and I want to look natural. That's the most common thing people come in asking. However, they'll point to one area. Let's go through the five most common and what to do about them. Number one is a specific line or fold, like a smile line. People come in and say, I just hate that smile line. Number two would be the RBF, or the downturn of the mouth. And even if it's tiny or minimal, people hate it. And when you make it better, you can make it 50, 70, 80% better. They'll still only see the 20% that remains. Third is the necklace lines. People obsess about the lines that go horizontally along the neck region. Fourth, brown spots or sunspots. People initially come in and say, hey, I got some freckles, I love them. Don't get rid of them, they're my hallmark. 5, 10 years later, fast forward, they come in, oh my gosh, I hate my freckles, I got brown spots. What am I gonna do about them? Or they'll have one spot that they want removed, yet they're not seeing the other 1,000. The fifth would be the under eye. It might be a minimal area of the under eye, like when they smile, there's a little extra fat, or there's a single line. I'm not talking about mid-face volume loss or deep tear trough or lid-cheek junction, but one little line under the eye that's natural when they smile. Let's go to what do you do about those. So a specific line or fold, and we'll deal with the smile line. That's a common one. If you look at younger people and they smile, they often have that fold, so it's not necessarily an aging feature, but in certain cases, if they're gaunt or hollow, people have lost weight, or they're thin and active, then it's the volume loss from the area in front of the ear or the preauricular area, and it's important to address not that one line or fold, but the whole face globally. PDO threads, PlasmaSculpt, all those things can be used. People think of dermal fillers, and while you can put a little dermal filler in there, it's really not the number one go-to treatment because it takes a lot of filler. There's no bone there to brace it. And it doesn't last that long because it's a movement area. So that's a full conversation. We're addressing the whole face, but particularly the jawline in front of the ear is important, yet it's only one line they're coming in for. It really isn't. The RBF, or downturn of the mouth. This has to be number one, even though we're talking about it second in place, because young and the old all come in asking for it. And they think, well, it's just a little line or fold here. That little line or fold is from some fat hypertrophy, bone loss, hyperdynamics of the muscle, loss of volume in the face, and ptosis of the fat. It's so complex, that downturn of the mouth, also loss of lip volume. To address it, is globally addressing the whole face. And you can imagine, it's not just the one line or fold, but when people look at you, they're looking at the whole shape of the face, square versus triangular, and the areas of volume loss. So, to treat that area, we do all the aforementioned. We do neuromodulators like Botox, Dysport, Xeomin. We do a little bit of filling. We do PlasmaSculpt and PlasmaGlo, and PDO threads, all combined for most people, depending on their age and stage. The necklace lines. Now, what we're talking about here is the horizontal lines. So I'm not talking about crepey skin or platysma banding, but the horizontal lines, particularly to me, are never really an aging feature, and you see them in the youth. a little bit of fat in the neck is a good thing because it you don't get the loose skin or the laxity as early. And of course, too much fat we get rid of as well. But the horizontal lines, simply don't obsess over them. Filling them, doing PlasmaGlow and different treatments, it really doesn't provide the result that the patient's looking for. So there's no good solution, but really, it usually doesn't age people. Stop obsessing. Sunspots. It's very interesting in the market because if you talk to the representatives of lasers companies, say, over the years, and they stop doing lasers for brown spots, there's a sense of relief. The brown spot market is very difficult because people look at one or two spots and they have one or 2,000, and it's specifically one spot that they just want gone away because it's aging them. It's the overall glow. So it's the projection of light, its pore size, its texture, its tone, it's all of those things together. Definitely stop obsessing over the one. There's usually multiple spots. Treating the whole face, and here's the key, treating it many times. So with a treatment like this, there's a lot of sun damage. You take someone in their 40s or 50s, it's a minimum of 4 to 6 treatments to get them back to baseline and reduce all of those spots. So many spots are deeper that you can't see with the visible eye, but from a distance, it affects light reflection. And light reflection is youth. People who have light reflection, youth, versus those who don't at an older age, make a big difference in looking younger. So stop obsessing about the one and treat the whole face. The under eye, probably the most difficult area for many to address. It's multifactorial, it's bone loss, rotation of the bone, it's fat pads, ligaments. So many things go into it, laxity of skin, collagen. There's the double bubble, or often the malar pad, and then the palpebral pad that people don't like. But it's the single line that I want to talk about that people believe when they smile and there's a line that forms, they can just perseverate on that. And that's really not an aging feature. And if you lift your cheek up and you don't move anything else, you can form that line. So the only way to really stop it is stop the cheek from lifting up, and that would be a paralysis of the cheek, and nobody wants that. It can easily be done with neuromodulators, but it's definitely not a good look. If you do skin tightening, if you try and fill it, it will look funky. It will not look right. Same with the fat pad on the lower lid. Although for the youth, it's actually becoming a sign of beauty. They don't mind it. But older people tend to come in if they've had it for years and they like it addressed. So it doesn't create an aging feature. The hollow, the tear trough, or the mid-face loss, that's a different story. That does create aging. It does create an aged look, and it can be treated now with the microcannula technique and platelet-rich fibrin. But that single line or the fat pad on the eyelid, just let it go. It's not what's creating age. So there's 5 obsessions and 5 treatments. The takeaway is think globally about addressing the whole face, and that usually takes care of the problem. When people look at you and determine if you're looking aged, tired, not right, they're looking globally. They're not looking at any one thing usually. And so that's one reason why we address the whole face. But the other is it creates the natural look that people are looking for. If you spot treat one of those things, often it doesn't make anyone think you're younger or look healthier. It might help your eye a little bit. Chances are people want it fully gone, and it's often not even possible. So thanks for joining me for this video. Join me further YouTube videos, also on Instagram, to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.